Ang karunungan ay kapangyarihan, and it's time once again to put that power to the test here on K-Check. Hello everyone, ako po si Attorney Gabby Concepcion and this is K-Check. So patuloy pa rin ang paghahanap natin ng mga gustong sanayin at palawakin ng brain power nila through competition. Ang tanong, are they up for the challenge? So samahan nyo kami until the final week of competition to find out who our next K-Check champion will be. So apat na contestants po ang dadaan sa ating karunungan check sa araw na to. Unang-una ay si Justin, who is a dentistry student of Centro Escolar University. He loved performing and public speaking back when he was still a home student. Now he loves to cook and is a certified foodie. Si Jean naman ay student of UP Diliman and is currently a fourth year BS Mathematics student. His hobbies are playing video games and listening to music. He also loves walking and spending time with his cats. Si Angel naman is a sociology student of UP Diliman. She also works as a dance coach for kids and adults beginners hip-hop. Her other hobbies include tarot reading, watercolor painting, and jogging around campus. And last but not least, we have Sarah, who is a creative writing student from UP Diliman. She loves watching anime and reading web novels. Currently, she's figuring out the details of her own sci-fi novel. So yung apat na contestants po natin will be competing under the watchful eyes of today's K-Check panel of experts. Siyempre, nandito si Professor Glessy Atienza of the College of Arts and Letters, UP Diliman. Nandito din si Professor Neil Santillan, former chairperson of the UP Diliman Department of History. And siyempre, last but not least, Assistant Professor Marla Endriga of the Department of Biology, UP Manila. At ngayon, contestants, handa na ba kayo for our first round? In this round, correct answers are 10 points each. So get ready to buzz in and collect those points. Let's not waste any time. Let's begin. Round number one. Question number one. Butter, mayonnaise, and vegetable oil are rich in which of the six essential nutrients? The correct answer is fats. Question number two. Robert Ballard led a team that discovered what ship at the bottom of the Atlantic Ocean in 1985? Justin.
The Titanic.
The Titanic is the correct answer. K-Check. Question number three. In what country in Africa can you find the Great Sphinx on the west bank of the Nile River, Justin?
Egypt.
Egypt is the correct answer. K-Check. In quick math, emphasis on quick, what fraction in lowest terms is the sum of 1/3 and 1/6? Jin.
2/3.
The answer is incorrect. Angel.
1/2.
1/2 is the correct answer. K-Check. Question number five. Also known for its great beaches, Da Nang is the commercial and educational center of the central region of what Southeast Asian country? The correct answer is Vietnam. Question number six. Ailurophobia is the fear of what common pet? The correct answer is cats. Meron bang cat person dito? Ayan. Hindi nila alam kasi wala silang phobia ng cats. Question number seven. Music for a sushi restaurant reached number 3 while late night talking reached number 2 in the Billboard charts in 2022? Which male singer recorded these two hit songs? Naku, mukhang wala dito na fan ni Harry Styles. Question number 8. What Asian country has been known in history as Yamato, Nihon, and Nippon? Angel.
Japan.
Japan is the correct answer. K-check. Question number 9. What sport is featured in the films Rocky, Raging Bull, and Creed? Justin.
Boxing.
Boxing is the correct answer. K-check. Question number 10. This time, the term Tomcat referred to the celebrity couple from 2005 to 2012 composed of Katie Holmes and which actor? Justin.
Tom Cruise.
Tom Cruise is the correct answer. K-check. Question number 11. Philip II was king of what European country from 1556 to 1598? Jin.
Spain.
Spain is the correct answer. K-check. Question number 12 and the last question for this round. A moth having yellow head scales was named after which United States president who had fluffy yellow hair? Angel.
Trump.
Donald of Trump. Course, everybody knows Donald Trump and his fluffy yellow hair. And that's it for the first round. And after that first round, we have Justin in the lead with 40 points, followed by Angel with 30, Jin with 10, and Zara with a bit of catching up to do. So ito na po ang favorite portion natin dito po sa K-Check, ang tinatawag natin K-Chika, para naman magkaroon tayo ng konting kaalaman tungkol sa mga contestants natin. Para din medyo mawalan sila ng kaba at nervyos. Mukhang kinakabahan kayo ng slight. So unahin po natin si Justin. Justin, sabi mo dati mahilig ka mag-perform and to speak in front of a crowd. Hindi na ngayon? Nag-iba ka na ba? At ngayon nga ay foodie ka na. So ano ba ang favorite mong pagkain sa lahat? Diba?
Pasta, syempre.
Syempre talaga.
Can't live without it.
Ano naman ang paboritong klaseng pasta? Ikaw ba nagluluto or kumakain lamang?
Mostly po ako nagluluto dahil nagdo-dorm po ako at ang kapatid kong mas nakakabata. And ang favorite naming pasta is aglio e olio, yung olive oil lang tsaka garlic kasi mura.
At ang pinakamadaling gawin, di ba? Pero bakit ayaw mo na mag-public speak?
Natakot na rin po ako sa madaming crowd kasi nagkaroon po ako ng medyo embarrassing moment sa tapat ng madaming tao.
Ay nako, pero dapat hindi ka mawalan ng lakas ng loob kasi huwag mong pinapansin-pansin yung mga yan, di ba? Go for it. But in any case, Jin, alam nating wala kang phobia, but why cat? Sabi nila, aloof ang mga cats, mga suplado at suplada. Bakit mo type ang mga cats?
Hindi ko alam. It's just ang cute nila kasi ang fluffy, ganun. Tapos compared to dogs, medyo hindi sila ganun kakulit. So, yeah.
Well, hindi sila yata makulit at all, no? Ang mga cats. Pero hindi ka ba nakakalmot ng mga pusa?
Ilang beses na rin po, pero nasanay na rin po. And trusted din naman po ako ng mga pusa ko. I trust them, so there's that.
Talagang he really has a relationship with his cats. So anyway, maraming salamat Justin at Jean. We'll talk to Angel and Sarah later. In the meantime, paghandaan po natin ang round 2. Susunod na sa pagbabalik po ng K-Check. Tuloy pa rin po ang ating karunungan check. Bago tayo magpatuloy, isang recap lamang. Justin has 40 points, followed by Angel with 30, Jin with 10, and Sarah with a bit of catching up to do. And as we promised, tapusin na po natin ang ating K-Chika with our last two remaining contestants. So Angel, ikaw naman, alin ba ang mas mahirap turuan ng hip-hop? Yung mga bata na medyo hindi pa makontrol ang movements nila o yung mga adults tulad namin na matitigas ang ulo at katawan? Uy, hindi naman.
Sa experience ko po, mas mahirap po talaga sa kids. Kasi pag may isang nagkulit, kunyari tumakbo sa studio, tatakbo na rin yung iba, so nagiging teacher na lang ako na tagahabol na ang kids. Parang kami nagpipreschool doon. Pero ayun, may mga assistants naman ako sa studio, so natuturuan pa rin naman yung kids na.
So if you had one favorite hip-hop pose, what would it be? At pakita mo naman sa amin.
Yung lagi lang ginagawa, basic lang, ganyan. Ayun. Or yung mga nakapisay, ganyan.
Ganyan?
Ganun.
So anyway, Sarah, why sci-fi as a first novel? And it's nice to know na ngayon pa lang alam mo na talaga kung ano ang gusto mong ma-achieve sa iyong lifetime. Why a sci-fi novel?
Actually, wala pa akong plot, pero parang may vibes lang at big idea. Like, yung idea ko is that the world is made up of some kind of code, and then there are some characters who can access this code and program it. Like, parang computer science, but instead of you're on a computer, you're programming the real world. So parang, I just think that's interesting and I wanted to explore where that goes.
So, siguro mga ilang taon pa kaya bago mo maumpisahan ang iyong novel?
Matagal pa. Like, I'm still in the world building phase right now. Parang, I'm setting up the world pa and answering any questions about it. Wow.
Siguro, maraming moments na talagang malalim talagang iniisip mo, no? But in any case, di ba? It's nice to know about our contestants. Marami pong salamat sa inyo. And it's now time for round two. So contestants, sandaan. Get ready to buzz in. But make sure you need to strategize in this round kasi correct answers are worth 20 points each. But you lose 10 points if you answer incorrectly. So, let's begin. This is round two. Question number one. In May 2024, which cat character from Japanese manga was paraded in Thailand to request for rain?
Doraemon.
Doraemon is the correct answer. K-check. Parang alam ng mga gumawa ng mga question ng mga cat lovers ang ating mga contestants. Question number two. Philippine time is 8 hours ahead of GMT. What does the G in GMT stand for? Yes, Sarah.
Greenwich.
Greenwich is the G in GMT. GMT means Greenwich Mean Time. K-check. Question number three. What South American country emerged as the world's top producer of coffee for 2023, beating out Vietnam and Colombia? Angel.
Brazil.
Brazil is the correct answer. K-check. Question number four. Which actress played the title role in the 2024 movie Furiosa, a Mad Max saga, as well as a young chess master in 2020 drama series The Queen's Gambit? Justin.
Anya Joy Taylor.
The answer is incorrect. Angel.
Anya Taylor-Joy.
Anya Taylor-Joy is the correct answer. K-check, medyo baliktad. Pero nahalata ako, Justin, pag medyo showbiz ang tanong, ikaw ang unang sumasagot. Question number five this time. Which singer hit the musical charts with singles Smooth Criminal? Justin.
Michael Jackson.
Michael Jackson, and of course, Thriller, affirming his title as the King of Pop. Michael Jackson is the correct answer. K-check. Question number six, this time starring Tom Hiddleston in the title role, what TV series was named after the Norse god of mischief?
Loki.
Diba? Sabi sa inyo, pag showbiz, mabilis si Justin. Loki is the correct answer. K-check. Question number seven, which Phil-American singer became famous for her collab songs Best Friend with Doja Cat and All Night with Ive? Sawiti, also pronounced as Sweetie, is the correct answer. Question number eight. Mount Ararat, the landing place of Noah's Ark, can be found in what modern-day country? This can be found in Turkey. Question number 9. Next to the Bible, what is the most distributed religious text with over 800 million copies worldwide? Sarah.
Quran.
Quran is the correct answer. K-check. Question number 10. What do you call the international competition for athletes with disabilities held following the Olympic Games? Angel.
Paralympics.
Paralympics is the correct answer. K-check. Question number 11. In what temperature scale is the boiling point of water 212 degrees? Sarah.
Fahrenheit.
Fahrenheit is the correct answer. K-check. Question number 12 and the last question for this round. Which United States president was shot while watching a play at Forbes Theater in Washington, D.C. in 1865? Justin.
Abraham Lincoln.
Abraham Lincoln is the correct answer. K-check. And that's it for our second round. So let's see how our contestants did after the second round. We have in the lead Angel with 110 points, followed by Justin with 90, Sarah with 60, and Jin with 10 points. Pero hindi pa po tapos ang laban, alam na alam niyo yan dahil habang may round, may pag-asa. At ang ultimate pagalingan round ay susunod na po sa pagbabalik ng K-check. Welcome back to K-Check. Pero bago tayo lumusong sa Ultimate Pagalingan Round, mag-recap muna tayo. We have Angel in the lead with 110 points, followed by Justin with 90 points. And then we have Sarah with 60 points and Jin with 10. Pero meron pa po tayong paparating na Ultimate Pagalingan Round. So dito, correct answers are worth 30 points each at may 15-point deduction for wrong answers. Remember, for this multiple choice round, contestants, we will accept the answer itself or the letter and answer, but not the letter only. So, let's go for those points and for the win. Remember, sa round na to, sa ating panel of experts, manggagaling ang ating mga katanungan. So, wag na tayong magpatumpik-tumpik pa. Let's begin. And to kick off the ultimate pagalingan round, let's call Prof. Glessy.
Maraming salamat. Magandang araw sa inyo. Si Andres Bonifacio ay isang aktor ng komedya. Ano ang pangalan ng grupong panteatro ni Andres Bonifacio? Letter A, Teatro Katipunan. Letter B, Teatro Kartilya. Letter C, Komedya de San Bartolome. Letter D, Teatro Porvenir. And letter E, Teatro de San Bartolome. Ang tamang sagot ay letter D, Teatro Porvenir.
Okay, maraming salamat, Prof. Glessy. Prof. Neil.
This refers to the use of biographical materials to construct group narratives. A. Diplomatics. B. Genealogy. C. Paleography. D. Prosopography. E. Numismatics. Sobrang nahirapan sila sa tanong. Ang tamang sagot ay letter D. Prosopography.
Parang ngayon ko rin lang narinig yung prosopography na yan. Prof. Nila, Prof. Marla.
Okay. There are times during the year in specific places when the sun is at its zenith and vertical objects below appear to cast no shadow. What is it called when this occurs?
Justin.
Lahay na noon.
Mali.
Sarah.
Summer solstice.
Mali. The choices are A. Perfect alignment day. B. Zero shadow day. C. Anti-blackness day. D. Intense sunshine day. E, Solar Penumbra Day.
Jin.
Solar Penumbra Day.
Mali.
Would you want to steal, Angel?
No.
Okay. In Metro Manila, there are two such days every year. And in 2024, they fall on April 29 and August 13. This is called letter B, Zero Shadow Day.
Maraming salamat, Prof. Marla. Prof. Glessy, again, for our second round.
Sino ang batikang artistang Ilonggo na ipinakilala sa pelikulang Oro Plata Mata at naging bida rin sa pelikulang On the Job ni Eric Mati? Letter A, Joel Navarro. Letter B, Joel Natividad. Letter C, Joel Lamangan. Letter D, Joel Torre. And letter E, Joel De Leon. Di nyo siguro napanood yung mga sineng sinabi ko. Pero yung On the Job, ang bida dito ay si Joel Torre.
Ang pangalan din niya ay nakakabit sa Chicken Inasal, di ba?
Yun yung iniisip ko.
Yung JT's, di ba?
JT's Inasal. Yeah.
Oh. Prof. Neil.
Known as the roof of Indochina, it is the mountain located in Vietnam, which is the highest point in the region. A. Fansipan. B. Mount Potaleng. C. Pomanlong Peak. D. Pusilong Peak. E. Talianson.
Sarah.
C. Pomanlong Peak.
Mali. Pinili ko tong tanong na to dahil major tourist destination to si Vietnam. Ang daming influencers ang nagtatampok nito. Ang tamang sagot ay letter A, Fansipan.
Okay, maraming salamat, Prof. Neil. Back to Prof. Marla.
Molecular biology. Which of the following RNA molecules serves as a template for protein synthesis during translation? A, mRNA, B, tRNA, C, rRNA, D, sRNA.
Justin.
mRNA.
Let me finish reading the choices. E, pRNA. The correct answer is A, mRNA. K-check.
Bago tayo pumasok sa ating third round, isang recap lang ng score. Si Angel is still in the lead with 110 points, followed very closely by Justin with 105 points, Sarah with 30, and Jin with negative 5 points. So, crucial ang next two rounds, correct? So, let's start the third round, Prof. Glessy.
Okay, sige. Maraming labong o tambobong ang tawag sa lugar na ito sa bandang hilaga ng Metro Manila. Ano ang kasalukuyang tawag sa lugar na ito? Letter A, Maykawayan. Letter B, Marilao. Letter C, Malabon. Letter D, Navotas. And letter E, Valenzuela. Ang tamang sagot ay letter C, Malabon, kasi maraming kawayan sa lugar na yon. Tambobong ang isang variety ng kawayan.
Maraming kawayan pero hindi sa may kawayan. Misleading talaga ang choices ni Prof. Glessy. Prof. Neil.
Yeah, sa kasaysayan ng Estados Unidos, sino ang Pangulo ng Estados Unidos ang nagbigay ng formal na pagkilalang diplomatiko sa People's Republic of China na nagbigay daan sa malawakang pagbabagong pang-ekonomiya noong panahon ni Deng Xiaoping? A. Jimmy Carter. B. Dwight Eisenhower. C. Lyndon Johnson, D. John Kennedy, E. Richard Nixon. Okay. Siya ay 99 years old at magdiriwang ng kanyang 100 years old ngayong October 1. Ang tamang sagot ay letter A, Jimmy Carter.
Last question for this round, Prof. Marla.
Okay, what is the term for the measure of the acidity or alkalinity of a solution? A, density.
Justin.
pH level.
Let me finish reading the choices. B, pH. C, viscosity. D, conductivity. E, solubility. The correct answer is pH or pH level. Okay, check.
Naku! Sabi sa inyo, hindi natin malalaman kasi after that last round, Justin is now in the lead with 135 points, followed by Angel with 110, Sarah with 30, Jin with negative 5. So nagli-lead na ngayon si Justin, pero Justin, alam mo na hindi ka pa pwede maging masyadong confident dahil may tatlong katanungan pa. So, itingnan natin kung anong mangyayari. Umpisa na po natin, Prof. Glessy.
Okay, sige. Pinatunayan ng mag-asawang Lamberto at Daisy Avellana ang gamit ng dula bilang pagkakataon ng pagsasama-sama sa panahon ng Hapon. Ano ang pangalan ng kanilang theater guild? Letter A, Avellana Theater Guild. B, Classic Theater Academy. C, Rizal Theater Guild. D, Manila Opera Theater. And letter E, Barangay Theater Guild. Ang tamang sagot ay letter E, Barangay Theater Guild.
Maraming salamat, Prof. Neil, this time.
Sino sa limang bayaning Pilipino ang anak ng Maynila? A. Emilio Aguinaldo. B. Andres Bonifacio. C. Marcelo Del Pilar. D. Manuel Quezon. E. Tandang Sora.
Naku, Angel.
C. Marcelo Del Pilar.
Mali.
Naku. Sarah.
A. Emilio Aguinaldo.
Mali. Si Marcelo Del Pilar ay mula sa Bulacan, Bulacan. Si Emilio Aguinaldo ay mula sa Kawit, Cavite. Ang tamang sagot ay letter B, Andres Bonifacio.
At ito na nga ang determining question, di ba? Ang last question for the last round will be from Prof. Marla and it will determine kung sino ang ating magiging daily winner for the day. Prof. Marla.
Thank you. What hormone is often called the love hormone? A. Insulin. B. Estrogen. C. Prolactin. D. Cortisol. E. Oxytocin.
Jin.
Oxytocin.
Okay, this hormone is associated with trust and relationship building. The correct answer is E. Oxytocin. K-check.
Diba? At least si Jin ay positive, diba? Sa pagkatapos ng ating ultimate pagalingan round. So, congratulations, Justin, who is our K-Check daily winner with a final score of 135 points. We'll see him again on Friday when he competes with our other daily winners for a spot in our semifinals. Maraming salamat din kay Jean, kay Angel, who gave Justin a run for his money, and of course, Sarah for joining us, and of course, to the members of our panel of experts, Prof. Glessy, Prof. Neil, and Prof. Marla. This has been Attorney Gabby Concepcion, who is now, we are all missing, Jules Giang. So see us again tomorrow for another round of competition here on K-Check.